Drowning is defined by respiratory impairment caused by the aspiration of liquid into the lungs. Water on the face triggers breath holding in the victim. Ultimately, when the victim can no longer hold her breath, water enters the airway and lungs. This sets up a cascade of injuries, leading to respiratory arrest and ultimately to cardiovascular collapse. Early treatment can help prevent morbidity and mortality. Treatment begins on scene with chest compressions and ventilations and continues in the ambulance until arrival to the hospital. Once in the emergency department, treatment begins with the primary survey, A, B, C, D, E. Airway. Any patient with respiratory distress, inability to protect their airway, or with traumatic injuries should have their airway secured by endotracheal intubation. Breathing. Continue the ventilations initiated on scene and in the ambulance, providing supplemental oxygen with the goal of keeping the oxygen saturation above 92%. Circulation. Continue CPR in those without a pulse. The most common presenting rhythms will be bradycardia, pulseless electrical activity, or asystole, so defibrillation is rarely helpful. Disability. Assess the patient's neurologic status using the Glasgow Coma Scale, as this is a prognostic value. Exposure. Hypothermic patients may require rewarming to improve chances of successful resuscitation. The history should concentrate on factors that may require further evaluation, such as comorbid illness, trauma, toxicologic ingestions, or attempted suicide. On exam, auscultate the lungs for rales, abdomen for gastric distension from water ingestion, neurologic status for alterations due to hypoxia, and finally, cardiac monitor for dysrhythmias. Most patients with any signs or symptoms will require hospitalization for further management.